So basic undoing strategies are what? Addition undoes subtraction, subtraction undoes addition, multiplication undoes division, and division undoes multiplication. So these two right here will allow you to get rid of fractions, since a lot of you don't like working with fractions. Okay, squaring will undo square roots. Square roots will undo squares. In general, nth power is unraveled by nth root, and nth root is unraveled by nth power. Just remember, you have to pay very careful attention to even root and odd root. When you are done, one nice thing about these problems are that you can check whether you have a correct answer, because you can always plug it into the original equation, and if it makes the equation true, then you have a solution. So that's one of the nice things you can do with solving equations. You can check your answers. So now let's actually solve the equation all the way. Not just work with getting rid of addition or subtraction, but actually find the value of the variable. And remember, whether it's an equation with variables in it or numbers in it, does not matter. Always the same process. Look for what variable you're trying to solve. And that's the variable you want to isolate. It's the y that I'm trying to isolate, because it says solve for y. That means I want y by itself and everything else on the other side. So what's the everything on this side here? Y minus mx equals p minus mx. How do I get rid of the minus mx? What undoes subtraction? Addition, good. So add mx on both sides then, right? So negative mx plus mx, those are what? Additive inverses of each other. Good. So y would equal mx plus p. Okay. Same thing will happen here, right? Remember. So if you're adding or subtracting, it's not going to do anything to the sign here. So you're going to have y smaller than mx plus p. All right, try that one on your own. What do you think we should do? Lots of stuff is happening here. Here we have negative 4x, and here we have negative 5x. Here we have 2/5, and we have 3/5. We want x by itself. So let's add 5x on both sides first. That will get rid of this negative 5x, because negative 5x plus 5x will be gone. So now we have negative 4x plus 5x is x, plus 2/5 equals 3/5. And now we can subtract negative 2/5 from both sides. 3/5 minus 2/5 is 1/5. So we have x equals 1/5 is the solution to this equation. What does that mean? If I were to put x equals 1/5 here, I will get left-hand side to equal right-hand side. And you can plug it in and check it for yourself. Look very carefully what happened. We had to do multiple steps here. So sometimes you may have to do more than one operation before you can isolate the variable by itself. You can do the exact same process here then, right? We're going to do what? Add 5x just like we did here. The only difference is instead of equal to sign, you have greater than sign. So x greater than 1/5 would be solutions here. So look at the difference between equation and an inequality. In this linear equation, linear just means degree 1. You got one solution. Whereas here, you're saying any x that is bigger than 1/5 will work, like 1, 2, 5, 10/5, 4/5. All of those are bigger than 1/5. As long as you have the number bigger than 1/5 and you plug it in here, this left-hand side will always be bigger than this right-hand side, no matter what the number is, as long as it's bigger than 1/5. That's what it really means to solve this inequality. Here, it means that x equals 1/5 is the only number, when plugged in here, will make left-hand side equaling right-hand side, which means if I take any other number that's not 1/5, like 2 or 4 or 3/5, and I plug it in here, I will get a false statement. Here, x greater than 1/5, you can say 1/5 is whole at 1/5 because it's not included, right? And greater than 1/5, so higher than 1/5. And interval notation would be 1/5 to infinity. So we've just reviewed how to write an inequality in algebraic notation, in geometric notation, and interval notation. So the solution can be thought of as, here's the algebraic solution. Here's the pictorial solution, and here's the interval notation solution. All right, try this one on your own. So first, in order to get the variable, look, here the variable is stuck inside the parentheses. So first, parentheses first, so I'll multiply that out. Negative 4 times t is negative 4t. Negative 4 times negative 3 is positive 12, plus 3.5 equals 6 minus 5t. So you can rewrite that 12 plus 3.5 is 15.5 equals 6 minus 5t. What should we do next, do you think? Yep, add 5t. Negative 4t plus 5t will give me t, plus 15.5 equals 6. Subtract 15.5 from both sides. So we end up with negative 9.5 is the value of t. What if you get an equivalent inequality here? You can do the same thing. You can see how there is actually no difference between equation and inequality. You're following the exact same steps, except instead of every time having to write equal to signs, you're writing less than or equal to, because that's what the original inequality was. So this is the algebraic solution to this inequality. This will be graphical solution. What do you think is the interval notation here? Go ahead, you have enough practice with interval notation from your previous homework, so go ahead and do that here. Pause the video and write interval notation for this solution. Negative infinity to negative 9.5, good. All right, go ahead, solve for y. Remember, solving for y means isolate y by itself. So can't touch this number until we get rid of this plus ax. So how do you get rid of the plus ax? You'd have to subtract ax. What allows me to add this ax and subtract this ax? The order I can switch because of what properties? Can you think? Oh, you can't forget the properties. Remember, you must remember all the properties you're using, because that's what's going to allow you to do the problems logically without having to question, can I do this? Can I not do this? You won't forget then what to do. Commutative property and associative property of addition is what allows me to add this ax and this negative ax, giving me just by equals c minus ax. I want to get rid of the multiplication, so I have to divide everything by b. And so that's my final answer. Y is now isolated by itself. You can do the same for what? Yep, you can subtract. That will still be preserved. Okay, but now when you do this division, we have to separate into two cases. If b is positive, then it will be exactly what we have here. But if b is negative, what happens to this symbol? The sign is going to have to switch, and then you can divide by b. So whether it's a positive number you're dividing by or a negative number you're dividing by, pay very careful attention and see what is happening. All right, now what here? Remember, we're trying to isolate the x. Add 3x to both sides. Negative 5x plus 3x would be negative 2x plus 2 fifths equals 3 fifths. Get rid of that negative 2 fifths. Okay, now what? So we have negative 2 fifths equals 1 fifth. So multiply both sides by negative 1 half. Why negative 1 half? Because that's the same as dividing both sides by negative 2. So you can either choose to multiply both sides by negative half or divide both sides by negative 2. Either way, you're going to end up with x equals negative 1 tenth. You can see negative 2 times x. So times, so multiply by its multiplicative reciprocal, which is negative 1 half. So multiply both sides by multiplicative inverse of negative 2, because that's how you're going to get the 1. You can do the same here. Up until what point? Up until, yeah, good, this point here. All right, so now what? If I multiply both sides now by negative half, what's going to happen? Can I leave it like that? No, this will have to flip. You see that? So I can't leave this symbol because you're multiplying both sides by negative. Right here, it needs to flip. Any questions there? Look very, very careful. Why is it flipped? Because you multiplied both sides by a negative number. So that's why those two have to switch. And so now what? Now you can cancel like terms, and you'll end up with x greater equals negative 1/10. So look at the difference between that and that, and this and this. You see the difference? Solving the process was exactly the same. The only difference was if it's an inequality and you're multiplying and dividing by a negative, you have to remember to switch the sign. So x greater equals negative 1/10. So here's negative 1/10 included. Greater equals would be all of that. So this is the algebraic solution right here, x greater equals negative 1/10. This is the geometric representation of the solution, all numbers above negative 1/10. And interval notation, what bracket are we going to use? Square bracket or round bracket at negative 1/10? Decide that. Yep, square bracket. Why is that? Because that means negative 1/10 is included.